Oh. What's up, everybody? Jomo here. If you clicked on this video, then I suppose I should commend you for having a good taste in video games, and probably, most likely, a pretty fun childhood, because that's probably when we all played this. But anyway, yeah, today I'm doing Ape Escape. It's just a real good game, and I'd rather have more than one game going on my channel at once. Anyway, yeah, if you're here, just feel free to chill while I play some Ape Escape, remember good times, all that stuff, and yeah, whatever. I'm just muttering random stuff, so let's start. So, new game. This was definitely one of my first games I ever played, like maybe in the first three. Good old opening cutscene. Let's go.
Hey, Spike.
Look at the way freaking Spike runs, or Jake, whatever his name is. Look at him. He's got his arms stretched all the way out to the side. Good old PS1 days. Look at it. It looks good.
Jake, over here, watch out!
Spike, the time station!
No, no, run you two!
Look at these devious little bastards. There's Spectre, look at him. The evil mastermind. Pretty sure he discovered, like, the professor's invention, which is like a cap that made him super smart or something.
It works. It actually works. We did it, Natalie. We did it. The time station is complete.
We don't have time for celebrating. We've got to do something.
Yeah, so now the Spectre is going to go back in time and try to change history so that the apes will rule the world. So good. And not only that, but look at, like, the overworld for the game.
Spike, can you hear me? You must listen carefully. Something awful has happened. There's been an accident. The time station has been activated by Spectre, and you're being transported back in time. You'll soon arrive in the Lost Land when dinosaurs roam the Earth. Spectre has sent the apes back in time to try to change the course of history. His plans for world domination have begun. And if we don't stop the apes, history will be changed forever. You're our only chance. Two of my gadget inventions, the Stun Club and the Time Net, were also caught in the transport. I want you to use them to catch the apes and send them back here. The Stun Club can be used to defend yourself against attackers. And when you use it on the apes, they'll be stunned. And you'll have an extra second to catch them at the time limit.
This guy ever stop talking?
There isn't time for any monkey business, Spike. Our fate is in your hands. We're depending on you. Be careful.
Yeah, so 8-year-old me, and we already got dinosaurs and a time machine. This game was just so amazing. Look at it. That monkey's all jiving out. Pretty cool. Oh yeah, the way that you would... Damn it. Hit enemies. So one thing that was so good about this game, obviously, was that the banana sprites. You had to actually use the analog sticks. That was like a big thing. Like, analog sticks. Holy moly. You can control the direction that you swing your... This looks like a lightsaber to me. I always thought of this as like a lightsaber, which made it really cool. I mean, the developers knew what they were doing. This game is already really cool, right? And then, on top of that, it's super fun. I'm gonna beat this guy up. So yeah, you're using that the analog sticks to run around, and to swing your weapon, right? So that's revolutionary already. Plus, this is PS1. These graphics are pretty good for PS1, I would say. You know, they're on top of their game. She just nods. She doesn't have anything to say to me. See, look at how cool this is. And the memories. We got a save station. Oh man. Alright, well. Welcome to the time station. Everything here will help you with your mission. Words and more words. Okay, yeah, so there's not much to do now other than capture a bunch of monkeys. But that's the beauty of it. So I don't know how long this recording is going to be. Maybe I'll go for 30 minutes, so it's not too long. 15, 30 minutes? We'll see how far we get. When you're underwater, I equipped it with an oxygen meter. I'm sending the thing to you right now. Try it out in the training. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful. Yeah, all right. I love how, like, when he warps in, he's like, I'm going for it. That's so funny. Oh, see? That's what I'm talking about with the analog sticks. Like, you could actually use R3. You can crawl around and you can play dead. That's pretty cool. And then you can swim underwater. That's actually pretty cool, too, I guess. I don't know. They did that in a lot of games back then. So whatever. Get the monkey. Alright, too easy. Here's the exit. Piece of cake. And then who's this girl? She's always there. I don't know who the hell she is. Some CPU chick.
I'm going for it.
He's going for it, you guys. So I can aw, he jumped. Damn it. Okay. Gotta get this monkey. No, he saw me. Look at that banana sprite. It's like, I think it's two-dimensional. God, this game is so old now. What was it, 98? Can't believe it. The jumping's kind of weird. You have to double jump pretty much right after you put your first jump in, or he just kind of falls. Climb trees. Yes. He climbs like a monkey. This guy's a beast. He can jump like higher than any NBA player. He can climb a tree in 2 seconds. Screw you, get out of here. You can take cover by pushing left stick in. This way you can crawl to the monkeys without being noticed. You can swing the time net with the right stick while under cover. Let's do that. He'll never see it coming. Take this, you bastard. Oh! Gotcha. Let me get this guy too. Did he? Can I even reach that? Jump, Spike! Oh, you can't reach it. Oh, Spectre Token. Spectre Token, I remember that's important. That's gonna unlock what, minigames? Minigames in this game are so good. I think everything in this game is gonna be like the best thing ever. That's the way this playthrough is gonna... Everything I'm saying is gonna be about how good this game is, I think. That's how it's been so far. I don't know, for me, the opportunity to take a trip back to my childhood and also 1998 and look at what they were doing is kind of cool. I read online that as far as programming goes, they had to like code these games in like C or assembly language. Which, if you know anything about programming, which I don't know a lot about programming, I'm a computer science major in college, right? But I don't know as much as I should, so I could be completely wrong about what I'm saying, but to have to program in one of those languages, that's like not really very user-friendly, kind of, they call it low level. That's kind of, it's easy to take it for granted how much work they might have had to do on a game like this. But I don't know. I shouldn't say much about that. I don't know too much about really how they design these things. But that would be a great thing for me one day, is to make video games. Something I could spend hours and hours of my life on and not get tired of it. Oh, let's go. Oh, get him. Three more monkeys. Get him. These guys are so easy. Wow. Yeah. Spike sounds so mature for a little kid. It's kind of funny. Actually, the voice acting in this game is really bad. You'll see what I mean later on. If you don't already know what I'm talking about, of course. Pterodactyl. Look at him. And the game's so old that, like, you can't see it because, oh my gosh, the depth of range of view. He just disappears because he's too far away. Wait for it. There he goes, he's gone. This used to scare me. I was like, oh, he's gonna eat me or something. I did not feel safe at all being anywhere near this nest. Let's get out of here. I don't know much about pterodactyls or whatever that thing is. Maybe he's a vegetarian. Maybe I'm perfectly safe. Also, what the hell happened to the eggs? They're all cracked. Means they either hatched and a dinosaur took off. Or like, I don't know. Who knows? This too. Oh my gosh, I couldn't handle this when I was a kid. When I was like 8? T-Rex, look at him. Oh my god. How does he not see me? Oh, he does. So, I remember way back when I first played the game, I could neither comprehend how to do this part, nor could I deal with how freaking scary it was to me. There must be another monkey somewhere on this level. Maybe not. But I'm not sure then how I would have caught this guy. Now it makes perfect sense. You make the T-Rex bonk his head, and then, I don't know, if it takes a certain number of times or what, but this guy falls off, you capture him, whatever. Oh my god. But yeah, this was just actually terrifying to me. Let's see if I can bait him to attack me. Come get me! Come on, eat me. Oh, there's another monkey there. Oh, I didn't know that. I guess I'll go... Well, no, I want to get the other monkey, though. But yeah, I'd always be too scared to look at the dinosaur, so I would just get the other monkey. Let's see, look, he fell off.
Yes!
Yes! The nod. Approval. Let's go. I'm the best in the business, baby. I'm the only one in this business. Okay. Well, what's next? Mysterious Age, Thick Jungle. Okay, so already out of the Dinosaur Age.
A monkey radar. It'll
the monkey radar.
Monkeys down. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful.
I have my volume pretty low on my TV. Kind of can't hear what he's saying. Very well, but I don't want the sound overtaking the mic. The monkey radar is a gadget for finding monkeys. Turn the radar by rotating the right stick. Yeah, okay, whatever. Go away. You need to tell me how to do everything. Okay. What do I press? How do I... Oh, damn. Maybe I should have actually paid attention. Is it L2? Huh? Hold on. Oh, I guess you can't... I thought there was supposed to be like a monkey cam and you could like look at the monkeys. Oh, no monkey in there. Oh, monkey in there. Oh. Wait, what? No monkey there? Monkey there. I figured it out. I'm amazing.
Mysterious time of the jungle ruins. You must navigate through thick jungles filled with beasts never seen before. Go on to explore the temple ruins, but be very careful. The temple is laden with treacherous pathways and dark dungeons. Oh yes, and you may have already noticed one thing. The apes have varying fields of vision, so in most cases you can sneak up on them by crawling around rather than running after them. You won't be noticed as quickly as you may low to the ground. You'll discover many great things on your journey, but try to stay focused. You must locate all of the apes. Every second that passes gives Spectre a chance to succeed. We're counting on you.
Well, you picked the right guy. I'm gonna kick Spectre's butt. Oh, there he is.
Just as it should have been from the beginning.
Spectre, what's going on here? What are you planning to do?
Spectre, oh yes. You're the monkey that performs at the amusement park.
What? He's that cute little monkey that everyone loves to come and see? But how?
Yes, that's right. I stumbled onto this incredible invention of yours, this Peak Point helmet, and it's given me remarkable knowledge and great powers. And now, I plan to rule the world, and I owe it to you, Professor.
Spectre, you must listen to me carefully. It's true that the Peak Point helmet will augment your intelligence to heightened levels when it's worn. However, it is still incomplete. It's never been tested and may be very dangerous to use. I insist that you bring the Peak Point helmet back to me immediately.
Bring it back? Are you kidding? I'm sorry, Professor, but it's too late. I've already made duplicate helmets for my new army of apes. There's no stopping us now. The future is mine! Don't try and trick me into giving this helmet back, Professor. I'm smarter than you. I even figured out how to use the time station. I've already sent my armies back in time to rewrite history. No longer will humans be the dominant species. I will rule this world. Don't bother trying to stop me.
Huh. Spike will find you. Just wait. You'll see. We're not gonna stand around and let you take over.
Spike? That little runt? He doesn't scare me. I've got a surprise for him.
Jake!
I've always wanted to go up against you. Now here's my chance. I'm gonna have a great time destroying you and showing you who's the real hero.
What's happening? What's wrong with you? Do you realize what you're saying? Do you know who you're talking to? Snap out of it! Pull yourself together! Can you hear me?
It's no use. Somehow he's been brainwashed and he's being controlled by Spectre.
That's right, Professor. You're very perceptive. The boy you see here isn't the same.
just right in front of him, just tell him he's brainwashed. And he doesn't care.
I'm in control, and no one can stop me. Especially not you. Well, I've got to go now, but I'm sure we'll be talking again soon.
Yeah, it's okay though, because that kid sucks. We're gonna totally own him every time we face him. Obviously, because we're the protagonist. Also, I just realized I completely spoiled that, but yeah, I don't know. It's not much of a story, really, is it? Also, yeah, the voice acting. That's why I had to keep chuckling. Oh, it's just funny.
I'm going for it.
What we got here? Okay, so I gotta equip the monkey radar. Let's put it on square. There's the monkey cam. Marquez. I'm gonna get you, Marquez. Ow, what the heck? Is that a bee? Oh, I remember these. Oh, they're creepy. If you think about it, just like a plant like that. And it just tries to swallow you or whatever. Oh, gotta get him. There we go. Oh, no. Get away from me. Okay, those bees are really strong. I think they might actually murder me. I'm not careful. What's over here? So I need a flying gadget. Can't come here yet. Oh well. We'll come back later. The first pass through this game is kind of just... you don't have to worry about much. Because if you can't get a monkey, it's usually just because you don't have the gadget. So all I really need to do... oh, I didn't know you could just hit those guys. Wow. Thought you had to let them eat you. Yeah, all you need to do is just kind of like breeze through the levels at first and just wait until you get the right gadgets, you know? Then you come back, finish them all off. And I don't know if they did time trials in this game or not. I feel like they did. Okay. This guy's got an Uzi, or, well, some type of machine gun. Oh no! Gotcha. Three more. Can I swim over here? Yep. Sure can. The rowboat. I remember the rowboat. Oh, yeah. God, the controls were challenging for me at first. Let's see. This guy. Look at him. This fish thing is huge. Wow. I feel like if I fell in, he could just eat me. If he really wanted to be vicious, he could just knock this little rowboat over. And then electrocute me once I'm in the water, and then he could eat me. Oh, God. Good thing he's apparently not too bright. Okay. Come on. Let's get to the platform. Jump out. Can I double jump out? There we go. Oh, okay. No, don't do that. So I gotta, like, rotate. There we go. Rotate. Jump off. Easy. Can I climb this? Can I climb this? Oh, nice. Sucker. Oh, a rainbow. Hey, that's neat. They actually put a rainbow in. Among all these not so fantastic looking sprites. I mean, they look good. They fit the environment well. Oh no. No. Okay. Clipping through the platform there. The boat is, I mean. Yeah, another thing I like about these old games is they had to be really creative about environments and stuff. Just because of their technical limitations. It's kind of, not that they're not still creative in modern games or anything, but it's just a different sort of mindset, I think. Where it's like, okay, we can't just actually do anything we want. I do think it can go pretty fast. Which is pretty great. Oh, you're giving me a hint. So I have to go through here. Go down. No! I failed. Attempt number two. Go. That was easy. Gotcha. What? Spectre coin over there. Is there a way that I can just... Oh, nice. I wonder how I would get that. I don't know. No sense in worrying about it. Man. Row, Spike, row. Hiya. Oh, shit. Didn't see you there. Mr. Plant thing.
Yes.
You did great. I did do great, didn't I? Thank you. What's her name, Natalie? I forget. Do I get the challenge? Oh, Dark Ruins. Because if I remember correctly, it's this stage, and then you get your first challenge against Spike. So it's already been 30 minutes, but I kind of want to get to that challenge. It's because I think it's really fun. Capture 6 monkeys. I never actually, when I was a kid, I never actually beat this game and got everything. Like, I never got all the monkeys. I think, I'm pretty sure I made it to the end of the game, you know, through all the levels. But actually, I found the game to be pretty challenging at that time. So, yeah. Huh, that's pretty cool. But yeah, I definitely never completed it. Maybe I'll do that. Most likely will. Ow! This guy's agile. Yeah, give me more tokens. Gotcha! Wait, hang on. First I gotta kill this guy. Why do I feel like there's gonna be a monkey around here somewhere? I do have the radar. Guarding the entrance. Such a vigilant guy you are, Kenny. Oh my god, they killed Kenny! Why'd I think of that? Oh. I think I can handle it, maybe. But I remember there's something cool if you get to the top of the ruins here. What does it say? I figured out the monkey's lights. Blue means all's well, yellow means it's on guard, red means it's in panic. When the monkey notices you, the lamp will turn red. Monkeys with red lamps are violent. Violent little bastards. Oh my gosh. No! Okay, I'm gonna try not to deal with these guys. God, this monkey's smart. He's like, I'm gonna go somewhere where the enemies will protect me. No, leave me alone, leave me alone! Leave me alone! Can I make it? Oh no. I did not make that. That cost me a life? I think it did. No, no, no. I don't like you. I don't like you guys. You guys are mean. Does that fall? Apparently not. This is the surface I'm walking on. Just like vines connected. Okay then. What do we got in here? I'm gonna getcha. Actually, let's see who this guy. Oh no, wait. That's what's his name? Kenny. Come here, Kenny. Ugh, got you. Kenny never had a chance. Yeah, this is really cool. Push this block off. And then it falls. It destroys that. And there's another hidden area. Isn't that cool? That's so cool. F- fire. It looks like a Geodude that's on fire. Can I hit him? Oh no. Get him. Oh, and then he self-destructs. I think it's a Geodude and he's on fire. Why are flaming Geodudes in this game? I'll kill you. Damn it. Take that. Oh. At first I thought there was some kind of invisible barrier here. Oh, if they see me. Okay, so I gotta crawl, and then I can pretend I'm dead. Sure. We gotta be ninjas. Let's go. Gotta get him. Gotta get him. Oh! No! 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 Oh, and he shoots rockets too? God, I'm a jerk. Oh no. He spotted me. What's this guy's name? Nuzzy? His short legs are speedy. It's kind of contradictory, isn't it? You would think that if he had short legs, he'd be slow. I guess he's speedy for a short-legged monkey. What the hell is that? Get off the switch. Why is it still blowing? Okay. Come on, get him. Nope, Spike, get him. Nope. Oh. Okay. I feel like this guy is really not worth it. I'm gonna try one more time. And then if I can't get him, that's it. If I can't get him, then I'm gonna give up. What the? Okay, screw this guy. He's not worth it. Oh yeah, I figured that out. Thanks for telling me though. Whoa, are you serious? Oh my gosh, let's do it. This would be terrifying. Like, don't misstep or you die. But Spike doesn't care. Oh my gosh. You got this. There we go. Spectre token. Okay, well that was worth it. Nobody here. Don't worry about it. Okay, well. That monkey is so resilient. He's gonna be hard to catch. I'll get him later. I just feel it'd be easier if I had certain gadgets. Sorry to come up out of the ground and beat you up like that and then capture you in a net. But that's just what we gotta do. The humans gotta stay on top of the chain. Brutal world like that. Oh. What do we have here? This is really cool. I never got this before in my life. If only the PS1 could render further than like what seems like a couple feet or yards. Alrighty then. That's the beginning. Let's go do that advanced level part. I wonder if I can get cookies from this guy first though. Give me cookies. Yeah, you kill him and cookies come out. Yummy. Wow. Okay.
Hi-ya! Hi-ya!
You're mine. One more. Okay, I can't go here yet. Oh, I like how they have his shadow like directly under him. It's nice to actually be able to tell where I'm gonna land. Some games that's a problem, like you can't, the depth perception is off. Especially older games. But I guess now that I think about it, I can really appreciate it that about this game. You know where you're gonna land. That's nice. It's a nice thing to have. You know what I mean? Like some older games, it's really difficult to tell where you're gonna land. Typically not very good ones. what's this? Who's around me? His name is actually Runt. Okay, well, he's fast. So I gotta keep that in mind. What? Evil monkey totems. I'ma get you. I'ma get you. You're mine. Please don't turn around. Do not turn around. Do I get the challenge now? Please tell me I get it. I really want it. This was fun. Yeah. Do I get it? Jake challenge? Oh, there's a whole nother level. Oh my gosh. Wow. Maybe I'll split this into two parts. How long have I been going? Yeah, 40 minutes. I'll probably split this up. Well, let's do it. Cryptic Relics. It's an interesting name for a level.
Look what I've got, a new gadget.
A new gadget.
The slingback shooter. Just pull back and shoot. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful.
That's kind of weird. There's no rubber part. Like, for a slingshot, you would need a rubber part. They didn't even put it on there. Oh, there it is. You can see it on the other side. Okay. Easy as cake. The L2 button. Okay, so that's how I can aim it. Okay. I dig it. No, leave me alone. I just read this. Three types of bullets, normal, flash, and guided. Okay, you can switch with R3, and you want me to try them out. Neato. Gotcha. Can you aim up? No, you can't. So I gotta actually. I don't want to use that. Actually, I could use one lock on, and I think get both of them. There we go. That's so good. Okay. Nice shooting. Good luck out there. Yeah. Thanks, Professor. Warning. Capture 5 monkeys. Oh, this music is so good. Oh, that's cool, dude. They put in, shooting stars? I don't care what anybody says. It might not be that impressive of an effect, but the fact that they went the extra mile to put in something like shooting stars in this level, or a rainbow in the other level, I think that's cool. I don't know, whatever. You're giving me some tactics advice. Which way do I want to go? Do I want to take the nice bridge that's nice and safe? Or do I want to jump across these rotating things that could easily cause me to die? I'll jump across the rotating things. And I'll die. Thank God this is a video game, right? Oh my gosh, the decisions. What the hell? Okay. That's what you get. Beat all of these creatures to death with my stun club, aka lightsaber. Let's see what it says about this guy. Frito, like the delicious chips, Fritos, needs clean underwear. Haha, sucker. Feel the power of the human intellect. Oops. I guess I gotta press select and not start. What am I doing? There we go. Oh, I can't. Let's shoot this guy too. Shoot him right out of the sky. I don't want to take a risk here. Wow, it stays there for a long time. Alright, now I know. Okay. Oh my gosh. I almost just ran straight off. Oh, why did I... Why? What was I thinking? Okay. I gotta go back. Salty run back. Let's go. Hi-ya! Every time he jumps. Hi-ya! Hi-ya! Why don't I just shoot it now? Yeah, there we go. No, I don't trust myself. I'd rather be overly cautious than dead. What part of history is this supposed to be? Still the Mysterious Age? I guess they call it the Mysterious Age because maybe we don't know that much about it. Also, there are light bridges. What the hell? That's some pretty advanced technology, if you ask me. Light bridges. A bridge of light. This is like Halo technology. This is like super advanced futuristic stuff. In the past. Conspiracy theory time. Okay. I'm gonna shoot this guy. Shooting you for my amusement. Get owned. How many monkeys do I have to capture still? I have no idea. Oh, I can't hit you. No. This. Run for it! Run for it! No! Don't kill me, please don't kill me. That was probably not worth it. Okay, And evil spider bastard, I slay you. Ow. There's something weird going on with the music here. Let's find out about this guy. Pushy little dude. Troopa. Like Troopa Koopa. Seriously. I wonder why he's so pushy. You gonna come down? Never had a chance. Two monkeys left. Maybe the reason that there's like bridges and light bridges and stuff is because the monkeys are just that advanced. And they're still losing to a little kid. Ow. Speed the camera, turn around with the L1 button. Oh, wait, what? I don't know, but I've already been doing that. Yeah, I was recently playing Ape Escape 2, so that's kind of the reason why I wanted to play this game. Which I might replay Ape Escape 2 just for the, like, as a Let's Play too, because I like the idea of having this series up there. I haven't finished 2 yet, but so far it's good. I like it. In here. Come on. What are you pushing? There's nothing there. Can I jump? Can you make that? No, because you suck. And you can only jump like 6 feet high. What's wrong with you? You can only jump that high. Alright. I'll get you. No. Clever little bastard. Hit him! Hit him! There we go. Special ammunition. I don't remember hitting that. But I guess that's probably what opened this way. Jesta. Looks angry, acts mean. Oh, he's a tough guy.
No.
Don't. What the hell is that? I'm okay. Come here, Jesta. Yes. Yes. Alright, now I get the challenge, right? Please. You did great. She's so encouraging. Yes! Look at him, he's challenging me. Oh, I love this.
I've been waiting for this for a long time. This is just between you and me. Follow me.
This guy thinks he's gonna beat me. He might, actually. I'm gonna have to laugh if I lose. Let's go. I'm gonna take you on. What is this jumping? Oh my gosh, he's running away with it. Can I do it? Can I recover? Oh yeah, he's screwed. We got him now. Go, Spike, go! We got him now.
Yes.
Seconds. Oh, you could time yourself and try to get better times. That's cool. This is a lot harder when I was little. I get 5 Spectre tokens?
I'll go up against you anytime you want.
He's salty. Money match me, bro. Alright, that's a pretty good... I think that's a pretty good point to stop at. I'm just gonna check what level I have up next. Krabby Beach. Oh, wow. This game's pretty short, isn't it? I feel like I'm already actually pretty far through the game. Level-wise. There's still a lot of collectibles and all that, but... not mean. Monkey book. Can I, like, read up on all the monkeys? Whoa. Hold on, data. I'm pretty much done, guys, so... yeah, that's about it for this part, but I'm gonna look at all these monkeys first. Helmet hair problems. Wants to watch wrestling. Huh, data. Just chillin'. Wondering when lunch is. Afraid of dinosaurs. Sleeps underwater. Won't go out in the rain. Scotty. Coco. Can handstand for days. That's pretty impressive. Jay Thomas, coming out of his shell. That's clever. Barney, can't get down. Marquez, knows great hiding places. Inside the freaking bee nests or whatever. Livingston, can disappear in a flash. What kind of name is Livingston? Never heard of that in my life. Seriously on the lookout. George. Herb, fools around too much. Dillweed, lazy little guy. That poor guy, his name is Dillweed, that sucks. I guess that's what happens when you're lazy. Stoddy, existential philosopher. He doesn't look like it. Stan, searching for gold. Heh, Kenny, guarding the entrance. Kratman? Gratman? I don't know what that means. Or what that is. Too afraid to look down. Mushy, worn out from running. Papow, crazy from solitude. I should probably have waited to look at this data after I captured all the monkeys in the level, but whatever. Slippery fast runner. Lamenting his... That's why it's worth it. That's pretty funny. Needs clean underwear. Yeah, I remember that guy. Pushy little dude. Shot a hole in his foot. Get wrecked, mate. Looks angry, acts mean. Tough guy. Oh, that's all the levels so far. Alright, let's actually save the game. Look at the background. It's like... let's overwrite this. 5.8%. It's like they took like... I mean, it's just such a basic background. But it works. Ugh. Old games. 14.1% already. Alright, well that's it for this part. If anybody's actually still here. If you're still watching. Yeah, thanks for that. And, it's just good to know that people are... If people are watching or, you know, whatever, so any kinds of comments or likes or anything of that nature is always appreciated. If you don't like it, you probably aren't watching anymore, but if there's anything that I'm doing wrong, let me know. If there's anything I'm doing good, let me know. That's it for this video, so thank you for watching, and I'm out for now, whatever.